So I think we're all pretty curious to know what's going on in the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone, formerly known as downtown Seattle. I mean, there are two stories at play here. If you listen to the Democrats, it's a block party. And if you listen to the Republicans, it's anarchy. What's happening? With rumors of extortion, people being assaulted on video, we've got an exciting deep look into CHAZ.
Hello, I'm the blonde politician.
Leaving the precinct was not my decision.
Hell yeah.
The point is, in the end, this is our street, it's our station. Whose streets?
Our streets!
Whose streets?
Our streets!
You fought for days to protect it. I asked you to stand on that line, to be pelted with projectiles, threatened, and in some cases hurt. Ultimately, the city had other plans and relented to severe public pressure.
Now, before we go any further, let's establish who exactly is in CHAZ. We know it encompasses protesters, but then there's also 500 residents living in apartment complexes and roughly 15 to 20 businesses. Are these people safe? Can they just leave and go to and fro?
We've been hearing from community members that they have been subjected to barricades set up by the protesters, with some armed individuals running them as checkpoints into the neighborhood.
And then there are armed border guards who question everyone seeking entry.
But this is completely safe. It's all done in protest.
Well, he ventured into the nation of CHAZ.
Well, right now it's too violent for us to go in. It's a little bit too scary for us to go in, because when you go in and you have a different opinion than what they would like to be seen on video, they end up harassing you and they assault you. I had a friend who's a reporter who got assaulted just two nights ago.
The anarchists in CHAZ really don't like Mayor Jenny Durkan. They want to abolish the police. So if they don't want any police, who's gonna help people? No worries, they have a warlord. They thought of this ahead of time. You ban the police and then you bring in another police. They call themselves the new police.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it's very original.
Ras Simmons' crew and him come up to this group. And this is what they say.
Yeah, we know. You don't know the owner of this place? Forgot, we are the police of this community now. We are the leaders of this community now.
So as you can see, the crew declares themselves the new police, the new owners of the town. And this is when things go south.
No, bro. Go there. Stop, bro. Go there, bro.
Stop. I'm not trying to
eat. Get your fucking hands off me, bro.
Hey, yo, hey, bro. Hey, you gonna book him?
So the full breakdown of this confrontation are as follows. Man was tagging over someone else's art. Raz and group approach and separate him from the crowd, chasing him for two blocks. He begins to film them with his phone. They take it from him. He tries to get it back, and they attack him, kicking him in the head and breaking his glasses. At one point, Raz threatens to shoot the man.
Meanwhile, Mayor Jenny Durkan is having fun tweeting the president. Unsurprisingly, President Trump calls for law and order, her response saying, "Oh, stay in your bunker. We're gonna enjoy the summer of love."
How long do you think Seattle and those few blocks looks like this?
I don't know. We could have the summer of love.
Woman, these people don't want you. Nevertheless, it takes the police on average 3 times the amount of time to show up in CHAZ if there is a crime. That's 15 minutes. And now that number is rising to 18 minutes this morning. Now, how would they know that? Because people are calling the police in CHAZ. Crime is happening.
You know, response times in this area of the city for violent crimes, rape, murder has tripled because these protesters have closed a police precinct. So people, it takes the average police car now 18 minutes to get to a call instead of 5 minutes. It's an untenable situation.
Word is nearby businesses are being told to shell out $500 for now or else.
But don't worry, everyone. They have a firm stance against someone doing graffiti over someone else's graffiti.